Sticky Trifle Podcast.
And welcome. It's good to be back, and I'm sure you're all getting excited because lockdown restrictions is taking a step down tomorrow, and we are going to start having fun again, hopefully. And I'm hoping my guest is about to get an MOT and a service, which is long overdue for the Sticky Trifle Podcast.
Sticky Trifle Podcast.
Welcome once again. And we're indoors. And Wima is this guy. It's John Buchan.
Yep.
Memsie Garage.
Yes.
Are you the owner?
Co-owner, me and my mum.
Co-owner. So your mum's, she's part of the deal in that.
Yep.
Now before we get started, it's been a while. It's number 32 actually we're on there. Your first guest in the comeback. For 2021 really, apart from Mervyn Rose. Mervyn Rose, he likes popping in about noon again. So I've got you a drink here. I was wanting to have a beer with you, right? But it's not really appropriate when you're in a garage, I suppose. I'm not wanting folk watching your video saying, it's alright, you can have a beer in the car in the way, yeah? Because John does it. So anyway, I've got you, this is Charlie's. That's a blackcurrant in Asia. We'll just see how this goes. I'll say cheers to you. Since lockdown's in Hawaii, out,
thank goodness.
Hopefully. So,
cheers, Abdi.
Nice, I like that. That's all right, it's fresh.
Right,
so, now, me and you, we've kept each other for a lot of years, actually.
Quite a few.
But one thing I've never done, and I feel guilty in my side, I've never bought a car for you, John.
First time for a Errol.
So I'm thinking in future, maybe I should buy a car for you.
Why not?
But we've been in contact in the past, and I've always been, if you got it in this colour, but you didn't hate that colour.
Yeah, that's right.
And that was my problem, so apologies about that anyway.
No problem.
Right, so let's start with Memsie Garage. If I'm aware and I'm right, is it 50 years you've now been...
50 years past last November.
Wow, so, and this was your dad that started this?
My granddad and my dad.
So, who's your granddad's name?
Same as mine, John Raymond Buchan. And say was my dad, I'm third generation.
Wow, so it's not often they keep the same first name.
No, it's not.
We can do that, and you've
privileged, honoured.
So did that mean, growing up, you kind of seen us for childhood, did you?
Oh, aye.
And it was this very place?
This very place. The workshop here was the first place.
Uh-huh.
Then a showroom we're in just now. Then the big workshop at the back. And then the other showroom at the side. So it's evolved over the years, Ken.
And so... was it like, it's been your blood basically, is it? Or was you always into cars
always,
when you were young?
Always.
Was that because your dad and granddad?
Oh, definitely.
Aye.
Couldn't wait from coming from school, Bible Street on, to the garage.
And so basically, so by the time you left school, you was pretty much up to date and kent what was happening.
I kent exactly where I was going and if I was going to want to do.
Aye. And so, there was never another option career wise for you?
Never for me, no.
So you was just like...
focused on God.
Was that a mechanic you was thinking?
Aye.
And so, had you do your apprenticeship with that?
I did.
Was it hard?
Aye. For our exam, we had to go Livingston to Motec.
For how long were we speaking from your senior?
That was a hell day assessment.
Hell day. And so, when you left this apprenticeship and thing, Was it just always this garage? You never did any other garages?
No, always been here.
Always this scene?
Always been here.
So it's like family run at the end of the day.
Oh, definitely.
It? Aye.
Aye.
Can I ask about your dad now?
Mm-hmm.
If I'm right, you lost your dad.
Did, aye, 18 years ago.
And if it happened, was it just natural causes with him? Or?
No, dad took a heart attack 10 years beforehand.
So it was like no warning for...
No warning the day
passed. I mean, it was a normal night. You'd seen him some last time and all of a sudden...
Well, the last time I seen him was driving up the road, my mum out for the supper.
Is there a lot of regrets for you, like, caning that he left without warning? No, is it?
I would have liked longer with him.
Aye. And it's just one of the things you have to accept.
It's one of them things, life.
Going and,
it's life.
And I can't how you feel about that kind of things, John. And I'll be honest, I'll just say, I was over at a graveyard for my dad was, and there was a lady, I was only me and this other lady, she was putting flowers in this grave, and it was lockdown, it was mm-hmm. a lonely kind of time. And I says, how's it going? All right. And we got speaking. And mm-hmm. it was your mum, actually.
Really?
Very strange.
Good grief.
So you can ask her about that. But I spoke to her at a graveyard. It was last year. I tell her where my dad was, and she can't.
Aye. Well, dad came here as well.
Which I can about, aye. So, but that was last year it happened, and that was in lockdown. And okay. The only reason I spoke to her, it was, see if in lockdown had happened, I think it was through some May time. So like a year ago, but it was a very lonely time. Nobody was speaking to each other. And as I was passing her, I just happened to mention. Mm. And then she told me how far she was. Okay. She says, oh, Malone and me, we've got a Memsie Garage. And that's my only deal that I've seen with her.
There you go.
So if she's watching us, you may be mine a face.
Oh, she'll watch it.
Maybe know where your heart on. I don't care. So. anyway, so Memsie Garage, it's been around 50 years now.
Mm-hmm.
And the plan is to keep it going. And
oh, aye. Well, my daughter, she works here. Sales assistant.
We're going to meet her soon, are we?
Yeah, well, indeed.
We'll meet her at the end. So she's kind of taking over with that side of things we sell in cars.
She's trying to keep up with me.
Which is very different than that, because usually, if you didn't mind me saying, when we're speaking about garages, you'd kind of class them as like a man's kind of trade.
Aye,
but
aye.
Times is changing.
Oh, big time. The thing is, we're hearing a woman here and a lot of women don't like dealing with men.
Uh-huh.
Puts a lot of women at ease, makes it easier.
Ah, yep.
Than it's a woman to woman or girl to girl kin.
Which I understand that.
Aye.
But I love why times is changing now and there's a lot more things happening and being accepted, especially for women and career wise.
100%.
Ken, so it's 100%. Great here. When we're speaking about Memsie Garage, how much folk works here? Because there's quite a few guys you've got in here about mechanics and that.
For nobody's here, I would reckon there's only about 10.
Wow, so it's quite a lot of stuff.
Aye.
And has it always been about 10?
Aye. It's probably usually aye. It's always been about 10.
Uh-huh.
Aye, from what's going right now, because with so much customers now, and well, every car gets washed and cleaned before it goes back to the customer. Because when a car comes in for a service, you know, can your car's been touched, do you? Really?
And it's a lot better now when you get a car and you can. It actually looks like it's been taken care of instead of just getting a car
absolutely.
Back and
aye.
Biden and White came in. So,
aye.
I was going to ask you now, how's lockdown been for a business and is it just, did you ever stop last March?
We stopped for 7 weeks.
And why?
Purely,
just because you had to? Or?
No, purely on the basis we couldn't get parts. Renault parts.
Right, okay.
Did about a problem, distribution, getting them tiles. Yeah. And if cars are broken down, we have to sort them.
Uh-huh.
So I just thought, well, if I can't get bets, we'll just close.
And so 7 weeks, and since that,
it's been all right. This time, it's been a bit tough for January to now, nae selling cars. I opted to do to the online click and collect.
Uh-huh.
People like to try before they buy.
And I was going to mention, it's great you mentioned about how you found it tough for January, I see you at all now, because... Mm-hmm. I felt exactly the same. I mean, like, I felt for Christmas onwards, are things like being really stopped for us.
Mm.
And your only option is going to the supermarket, and face masks have definitely made an impact, as in social communication is now
definitely.
Missing. And even for that, as an example, I'm coming in here, I'm kind of scared. I'm buying a waffle, but I'm going to, because I'm scared because someone's going, that guy's too close, hey, look at this guy. So I'm kind of watching for that, but it's a very different world we're living in. I'm kind of scared that we're not going to get a community back for Abdi right, sticking Errol. Each other.
You could be right.
Or maybe going either way for Abdi's dying to get back out here, and finally we hear end of face masks and that, but till this face mask keep going, I think it's causing us a bit of mental health. As an example, I don't care about you, but Stephen, if you're out and about, I'm finding it hard to speak to folk the same now.
Well, you can't get close to them for a start.
Or they maybe run away from me, I don't know. Remember Stephen, oh, here's this boy, look, sticky trifle, boy, here he goes. Where you go? But it is more difficult now, so I just wondered about it. So, see a log doing now. How about your activities? Because I ken you've got a pretty big hobby you deal with now.
Oh, aye, well, the stock car racing, that was curtailed last year.
And that's nae back yet?
Or is there plans? It's starting just coming up. Beginning of May.
Right, so it's just coming up just now.
Yeah.
And that's nae face mask when you're driving, is it?
No.
Right,
no.
Okay, I just wonder.
I reckon Abdi will be spaced out.
Right.
There will be face masks when we're in contact with folk,
uh-huh.
I would reckon. There's no spectators.
Well, is this just because of coronavirus
yes,
thing?
Yes, there's no
and that'll
spectators.
Be bound like that till...
Well, probably a month or so, I hope.
Mm-hmm.
But we need to get back. We need to get a wee bit more normality and so for our mental health.
Have you won awards with stock cars, by the way?
I've won quite a few, aye.
So you've got a heap of different awards for coming first and stuff?
I've been track champion for 15 seasons. I've been Scottish champion.
Does that put you in like Lewis Hamilton kind of
nah.
stage around Aberdeenshire? Maybe it does. You're still winning things?
Oh, aye.
Right, okay.
I haven't lost it yet.
Right. And how's that? Is that due to experience?
Experience a lot to do with. Car building has a lot to do with.
So you're fine-tuning that thing enough and you're...
My car's done a breakdown.
And some of those, you've watched that happen?
Oh, aye.
Aye.
Most of the races won in the workshop.
Is that an expensive thing with the stock car racing now? Because I presume if you're putting in all this parts and making
can't
go
be expensive.
A certain speed, so...
Can be expensive. For most of my career, I raced hot rods. They were pretty expensive.
And
they
was this at Crimmin?
I raced around Scotland.
Right, okay.
I've
so
done every track in Scotland.
Only Scotland?
Only Scotland. I haven't done England yet.
Find you retiring for stock car racing, by the way?
If I'm able.
Right, okay. So there's a certain age, nobody's got to leave it?
There's a certain guy at Crimmin, Jim Riddle, I believe he's in his 70s.
I didn't care, still
racing, but purely because he hasn't stopped.
Uh-huh.
He's got to a certain age and he's kept going. If you got to like 60, 65 and then you applied for another license, I don't think he'd be granted a license. But because he's purely raced every season, he can still get a license. And he's medical, I suppose. So he's a fit guy.
When we're speaking about stock car racing, is it like an adrenaline rush for you now?
Big
it happens
time.
With you, aye.
Big time.
And for kind of speed, just say you're hitting the top speed. If it would be a top speed you're hitting here?
In a national hot road thing up to about 19 second gear.
Wow. So it's, and are his crashes?
Oh, it's crashes, I've been in him.
Never seriously hurt?
Never broke a bone.
But are his folk at his?
Oh, his folk have been hurt, aye.
And so how did you get into that, by the way?
My father again.
Did he used to do it?
Never did it, but always used to take a suit to watch.
Aye.
And then we just liked it.
That's a bit like my dad. My dad used to film with a camera all the time, and now here I am sticking a tripod up all over the place.
I had a stock car license before a driving license.
Right, okay. So you're keeping that going, a stock car license?
Keeping that going, aye, yep.
Aye. Mm-hmm. Now let's just say this hobby is have to stop doing line.
Okay.
What else would you be doing apart from it? Like, how's your weekends, like, right now? Because what do you get up to when you're away from this place, I wonder? Because there's not been stock cars, right?
So nothing.
What have you been doing instead?
Mother hobby is restoring cars. Like one set.
Classic cars? So we've got a Mini?
It's a Mini Cooper S.
A Mini Cooper S. Mm-hmm. How old is this thing?
1963.
And so it was... Was this your dad's or
no? That actually belonged to a friend. He had it for 30 years.
Wow.
And I got offered to buy it to restore it.
And this thing goes out for a blast sometimes, doesn't
aye,
it?
Aye, noon again, aye. Aye, yes, okay. Aye. Oh, aye, it's full road legal.
We've got a chopper here. For this shop I came for?
That came for a friend.
You've got a lot of friends?
I've got a few friends.
Aye, right, okay.
He was going to want to sell it, and I just put my hand up and says, I'll buy it. I like retro things and things that was in my youth.
It's fun to go, is it?
No, it's horrible.
It's not, right, okay. It's this great big handlebar, so it's a bit awkward to go.
Hey, folk come out the garage and see it, oh, I'd one of them, and that's great. And
so this was 70s, am I right?
No, that would be probably 80s, right, early 90s, because the airlines, the Mark 1s that Abdi had, the gears were there.
Right, ours were a stick, weren't they?
Yes.
Right, okay. Wow. Yes. So this is the kind of things you get up to.
Aye, I knew I'm on a Mark 1 Escort, RS2000,
right, okay.
One owner.
Is it going yet, or it's...
It's nearing completion, it's probably about 90% finished.
Do you take us things to car shows and
yes,
stuff?
Yes, I took him to the Vintage Car Rally, I've been to Glam's, I've done a couple of other events with some of my cars. Uh-huh. I built a car, it's through in the showroom, a Metro 6R4, a rally car.
Wow.
It's a replica. It's got a 300 horsepower Hayabusa engine in the back.
See, I didn't ken a lot about your horsepowers and that stuff, but I ken it's powerful, is it?
It's fast.
Aye, right, okay.
It's fast.
Now, going into family life now.
Mm-hmm.
You're married?
Yes, to Aileen.
And I ken her. Yep. I mind that name.
Aye, there
is she blonde hair?
Yes.
Attractive?
Yes.
Is she still attractive?
Yes.
Right, okay. And well, she must have been, because you've had three kids, have you?
Aye, three kids, yeah.
So you've got Sophie. Which... We're going to meet shortly.
Yep. John.
John.
Yeah. And Olivia.
Olivia. And how's the family life with them three anyway? Do they make your life quite fun and...
Oh, happy.
Aye.
Good
and
kids.
TikTok and Snapchat and stuff?
Oh, not the time. Just youngsters and mobile phones, is it?
I should do a documentary. I'll come and bide in your house and we'll film the whole three of them on their phones. See how much time they spend on their phones. Same as either of the other youngins, so, but it's, I learn a lot, I feel like I do learn a lot off of younger ones because they've got nice technology and there's some stuff again. For some stuff you're doing.
Hey, we're learning another thing.
Aye.
Learning another thing.
And why, like when we was little, we didn't hear any nice technology. We didn't have Wi-Fis.
Nah, we had nothing.
Bikes and go-karts and stuff, I presume. But it's a different world to what we was used
Big
to.
Time. We made D with what we had. We'd very little.
But how do you find your phone anyway?
Oh, great.
Aye, so do you
photos and Facebook.
There we go. Same
stock car.
Sticky Trifle.
That as well, aye, yes.
Sticky Trifle and aye.
Oh, aye. I like a podcast,
That's fine to hear. But aye, technology very up to date nowadays. And if I notice if you haven't got Wi-Fi, you get annoyed.
Oh, aye.
And so that's strange because we was never brought up like that. But our son,
nah.
You don't get a right signal or... If it's a passcode, it's not like mine. You feel like you're dying.
It's a lot of life.
Feel like you're dying if you don't get on a
passport. Your right hand's been cut off.
So technology has moved on a lot. Do you use technology to sell your cars?
Yes, we've got a configurator at the back. You just go into the car you want, change the colours, change the trim, fancy top model, see kind of wheels it's got, things like that.
And it shows you exactly
aye.
The type you want.
It's hard for somebody to look at a brochure, that's a colour road, but you can't really see it.
Mm.
Again, but the configurator, it's a proper car, and you can tailor it, and it's good.
Uh-huh.
It's good. A youngster's going on, you're
because they're so up to date with our touch screens and our thing.
You see the other folk come in.
Only a week less they're touching other again. Does this thing work? Is this thing work?
It's just the same as a phone.
Now, summer could be a very strange affair, as we can.
Well, there's going to be any holidays, nobody abroad, and I think.
So now might be a good time for folk to be buying a car.
Oh, absolutely.
If they was thinking about, am I in a holiday this year, are we in a car? So
definitely. It did, strangely enough, that did happen last year.
So
we sold a lot of cars on that basis.
Same effect this year coming up, probably.
Probably more likely early.
If I would hold as yourself, are you a holder guy? Because I presume you didn't like leaving this place,
nah,
do you?
Nah, really. We've got a motorhome.
And so you're far around Scotland?
We've just done Scotland week. We're all going to England sometime.
Mm-hmm.
To probably motoring events of some sort.
So, motorhome and you're not
well
fun of going out, you wouldn't have gone abroad holidays?
Oh, like abroad, no?
Aye.
I wouldn't have gone abroad this year, like.
I don't think Nino as well.
Nah. Nah, I like his son.
Aye.
Love his son.
That's why I came out and filmed today. It was half a bonny day.
It's a cracker.
I was out doing a bit of filming. Now, looking at a future in our retirement, as age is a war for you, obviously.
Hope so.
But is there a day you're going to think, Kinnis, it's maybe time to let the dreams take over here?
I don't care nothing else apart from work.
Aye.
I'm here 7 days.
Aye. And is it just, it's like in your bleed, basically. Oh,
I'm a nightmare.
So, like, at weekends and all, you're open to weekends and all, are you?
I am.
Saturdays, Sundays?
Hail day, Saturday. See if it kind of day it is, Sunday. But when the stock car starts, I'm a one on Sunday.
Aye. And then, how does that play in with, like, your wife? Because I'm sure she's going, are you joking? You're going, I thought it was what a day yesterday. Is there many times of that?
Nah, she's pretty independent, like.
Right, okay.
Thank goodness.
That's fine. So you've a good relationship at why we, you get plenty of time for doing stock cars and whatever.
Oh, she comes in, huh?
Oh, right, okay. Right.
She makes a coffee and nothing.
Family event.
Oh, aye.
We really should do a documentary with John, actually. I'll maybe film this family and see if it happens.
It'd be interesting.
I bet would. So, are there things for the future? Is there any more plans in the future? It's just going to keep us going the way it is.
Survival, Errol. It's going to be tough, I think.
For Abdi, and I think we're all speaking the same lines, that the money isn't really going to be an issue for folk new, as in how you spend it, because I think Awa's tightening up.
Oh, big time.
Awa's going to be kind of a bit more sceptical about, can we do this now? We can't do that now.
That's right, 100%.
Strange for our businesses.
Well, even Aberdeen's been in furlough, okay? I mean, that's been 80% of their wages.
Yep.
No overtime or nothing. A lot of folk need their overtime to up their wages. And
so, is this the end of the lockdown, Shank?
Couldn't tell you, honestly. I hope so.
Have you had a vaccine yet?
I haven't yet.
Right.
Alien is.
Are you going to be taking a vaccine?
Yes, definitely.
I'm taking a vaccine now, and I get. Because I'll be honest, there's some folk I'm speaking, they're going, didn't I take a vaccine? Didn't I take it?
A lot of them's changing their minds, though, once they start hearing if it's happening.
Well, I find it strange that folk is kind of saying, need a ticket, when they don't know how it's going to affect them in future.
I think the side effects of the vaccine be better than the illness of the COVID.
That's exactly how I'd agree with you.
So, I think, personally.
Right, very interesting. Now, I see Sophie here. I see Sophie coming here. Is she coming over?
She's coming over.
Sophie's coming over to speak with us very quickly. So, good to meet you, Sophie.
Hello.
How's things?
Fine, how are you?
Right, so, as far as I'm aware, you've kind of started to turn into a wee bit of, like, a sales assistant?
Yes, I have.
And how are you liking it?
It's different. It's different to what I was used to before.
Is it kind of strange to get folk to buy cars and all? I was thinking that, because you're meeting a stranger, right? Somebody comes in and goes, I'm looking for a, how much is this thing? And have you tried and like get them to,
well,
like a car? Was that the right?
The thing is, and I'll interrupt here. Shoot about my experience. If folk are in to look at a car, approach him, be nice, no pressure.
No.
You're not get pressure here.
No.
And once you've got a bit of their trust, it just happens.
Aye. But it's also is it like about getting the car up person once in a while?
Oh, definitely.
See, like, as an example, when I came to UF4, I was wearing a blue car, a certain type, and you had it in a different colour, and even to me, a colour of a car is important.
Well, that's the main thing you see.
Aye.
You have to live with.
Yep.
Oh, I wish I never took it. We want folk to know what happy.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
We will not sell them something if they're not 100%.
But if that's what they want, we'll try and get it.
Oh, definitely, aye.
Yes,
we usually do.
Yeah.
And so, your future, Sophie, do you think you're going to be doing this for?
I'm in it for the long run, I'm afraid.
So, down the line, you'll be saying, Dad, can you get a wahey?
No, I don't think so.
I interfere too much.
But it's great that you're keeping us in the family. But it must be, is it awkward enough sometimes? Because I've never had to deal with a family business, but is there sometimes it's too close?
No. Me and my dad got on really well. That's how we kind of was getting to work. So it's been fine. I'm been here, he's been here. And now for a name, we kind of meet up for a catch up, but it's fine.
And you had never plans about like, He's going, Dad, I think I want to debut your hairdresser. No.
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 No. When I was younger and looking for a job, there was not a job here for me to hay, so I went into Cairn to start with.
Aye, right, okay.
And I just worked my way up in Cairn, and then when lockdown happened, and November came, kind of, I was kind of fed up with what kind of side, it was
yep.
hard.
Yeah.
And there was a retirement within Memsie, so it was fine. It just uh-huh. happened at the right time, and it was...
Happened at the right time for bailers, really.
Yeah.
Aye. So you're learning loads off of him, I presume,
oh,
are you?
Definitely. And it changes all the time, so uh-huh. it's fine to hear. We can bang
if you ever hear an argument with him, if I win a lottery, I'll buy your business and I'll give you a better deal than him. Okay.
We'll hood up to you.
I'll pay you double at Christmas and all.
Perfect. Christmas bonus.
Yeah, I didn't say anything about a bonus, but that's a good idea. Well, maybe that didn't think, John. And then the Aberdeen will be leaving us girls saying, Memsie Garage, boy, Errol doesn't care a thing about his girls. So, right, hoping you are the best for a future, Sophie. We are a sales assistant thing.
Thank you.
And hoping our thing goes good for the future now with you.
Aye.
And stock car racing continues.
Hey, I had my glory when I was younger. I'm just in it for a crack now, like, honestly.
Aye, but I still that buzz, you oh, like that buzz.
I've seen you start a car and...
Aye. What I do.
Aye.
What I do.
Aye.
And congratulations, in 50 years, now a lot of garages can say that they've gone 50 years and counting. So it's a very impressive record and all. So before I go, thank you for being on.
Hey, thanks for being me.
I'm chuffed you're on, actually, because we spoke about it.
You did, aye.
It was a couple of months back, and I said, he might be too busy. Because you kind of was going on, it's all right. And then I got you to change your mind somehow. I was like, oh, he's maybe actually thinking about it.
Ah, good for bathers.
And then I've met Sophie here, so all the best for yous.
Thank you.
And thank you for being on Sticky Trifle Podcast. I'd like you and Fuzzo in the next scene, but keep tuned and we'll find out.
Keep watching, guys.
Right. See you next week. See you.
Sticky Bye. Trifle Podcast.
Memsie Garage continues to keep it in the family. And it's still got me thinking, maybe I should take John up in his offer and I'll buy a car for him someday. But not one of his hot rods or stock cars. And I've always kind of thought that if you don't connect with a car when you sit in it the first time and do a test drive, you'll never really connect with it.
Sticky Trifle Podcast will return next week.
And this guy could be on his way for a vaccine jab appointment. And me, I'm getting on my bike.
Sticky Trifle Podcast.